Hello friends, we are here to discuss about introduction to resistance welding. First of all, let me introduce myself. I am Pulkit Srivastav, assistant professor in mechanical engineering department at Noida Institute of Engineering and Technology, Greater Noida. So today we will discussing about resistance welding. As we know, there are lots of welding processes which are being used in today's scenario. So one of them is resistance welding, which is having very wide applications in engineering as well as other household and some other fields where resistance welding has huge applications. So moving ahead, let us discuss what is resistance welding. Resistance welding is basically the welding using high current and low voltage. High current and low voltage. So, resistance welding is a pressure welding technique using high current and low voltage. Please make a note that pressure is applied. Pressure is the most important thing. The current passing through the two overlapping work pieces causes local heating. Local heating, local heating due to internal resistance of work pieces and temperature of metallic pieces rises to the fusion point due to the resistance offered by the work pieces in the flow of current. Subsequent applications of pressure results in permanent joining. This is the reason why resistance welding is used, that no wastage is done by the formation of weld without use of filler metal. Work pieces are placed between two rods or roll wheels. It is dependent that whether we are to create spot or whether we are to create a seam. Seam means straight line, which serve as a conductor for producing welds. AC electric current is supplied through copper electrodes or rolls connected to the secondary coil of a welding transformer. It is used for welding thin sheets of the similar metallic materials. Please note this point also. Similar metallic materials only can be joined, preferably. Then this is simple process which is explaining the resistance welding. Here are two electrodes through which high current passes through these two workpieces, and in between them the weld occurs. So to explain it more better, if these are the two workpieces and these are the two electrodes, then when the pressure is applied, remember current is passing through this, okay? Current is passing through this, then welding will occur in between these two pressurized electrodes. Process both heat and pressure applied to the induced coalescence. Heating I square R T, the resistance is given by this equation, electrode, workpiece surface contact, all these create resistance, and this resistance is used for producing heat under pressure. Pressure is done to hold the workpieces and for collisions at lower temperatures. When it is too low, high contact resistance is there, surface burning happens. If too high, then soft metals expels and deformation occurs. Here in this equation, in this particular equation, H is the amount of heat generated at the contacting area of the elements to be welded, I is the current in amperes, R is the resistance of the circuit at contacting area, means here, resistance in this area, and T is the time for which electric current is passed through the joint. It is most preferably 0.25 or 0.3 seconds mostly. Now, let us discuss furthermore on this topic. The following metals may be welded by resistance welding: low carbon steels, aluminium alloys, medium carbon steels, high carbon steels also, and some alloy steels are also may be welded. The advantages of resistance welding is high resistance, high welding rates, low fumes, cost effectiveness, easy automation, no filler materials are required, this is very important, and low distortion. We do not need any filler material. Disadvantages are also there for resistance welding, that is high equipment cost, low strength in case of discontinuous welds. So, we have to think before using this technique. Thickness of the welded sheets is limited. This is also a very important drawback. It is limited up to 1/4 inches only, that is approximately 6 mm, and not more than 6 mm. We cannot use resistance welding for sheets more than 6 mm. This is very important. 6 mm is the last limit for producing resistance welding. Applications of resistance welding. Resistance welding is used for joining vehicle body parts. It may be used for fuel tanks, domestic radiators, pipes of gas, oil and water pipelines, wire ends, turbine blades, railway tracks, and many more. It is also used for household utensils. You must have seen the water jugs in your house, which are made up of steel. In the handle of the water jug, you can see those 2-3 spots are there, which are joined to the body. If this is certain utensil or a water jug, and its handle is jointed here. So, this portion, the joints are having 2-3 dots. They are simple example of the spot welding, resistance spot welding, and seam welding is also there. Seam welding means, other than spots, continuous line of welded joints between two sheets is there. Butt welding is also there, flash welding, resistance projection welding. These are also different types of resistance weldings. So, we will discuss each of them one by one. So, talking about the spot welding, resistance spot welding, abbreviation is RSW. The force is applied between the two electrodes from both sides, so that it is properly held between the two tips, and then power supply is switched on to pass the current, and in between the current the welding occurs in this particular area between the two electrode tips under the pressure and high current. This figure is clearly showing diameter of the weld spot is in the range 3 to 12 mm. Okay. 3 to 12 mm, here the spot is created between the two electrodes after applying the force. Okay. Sheet metal parts, these are the sheet metal parts, and weld nuggets is here, and these are the two electrodes. This figure is showing resistance welding with all the components of spot welding, the main process in resistance welding group. Remember, spot welding is the most widely used application of resistance welding as compared to seam, butt joint and projection welding. Spot welding is the most widely used application of resistance welding. Spot welding cycle we can discuss in the manner that here in this first figure, no pressure is applied between the electrodes, then force is applied on the two objects. Okay, force is applied and these two are held, but current is yet not passed. And then in this third figure, the current is being passed and molten metal is happening at the junction of the two electrodes. Then removing the current, the force is already is not removed till now, and then in the fifth figure the force is removed, the two electrodes are separated away. So, this figure can be represented using this particular graph of force current and the time duration between the process. In the first process, we can see here no pressure is there, no force is applied. So, flat line, nothing is happening. Then as the force is applied in the second, the force is here, and then current is starting. In the third zone, the force is also there and the welding is happening in this particular zone. This particular zone, the weld happens, and then as similar to the second, fourth is there, and in fifth, the last stage of this spot welding cycle, there is no force applied. So, discussing some more points about the resistance spot welding. Spot welding is a resistance welding process in which two or more overlapped, remember, overlapped metal sheets are joined by spot weldings. Overlapping, you must be knowing, overlapping means one on another. One on another is overlapping. Like this, two sheets are overlapped, if we say, then here the spot will be done. Okay. So, now moving ahead, the method uses pointed copper electrodes. It is not mandatory that it should be copper, but copper is most preferably used because of its high electrical conductivity. So, it is using pointed copper electrodes, which provides the passage of electric current. The electrodes also transmit pressure required for transformation of strong weld. The diameter of the weld spot is in the range 1/8 inch to half inch, means 3 to 12 mm. It consists of transformer core having primary and secondary winding. One end of the secondary winding is connected to the upper electrode and other electrode is connected to the lower electrode, as it is shown in the previous figure. The work pieces to be weld are pressed between tips of the electrodes and high current at low voltages is passed through the workpieces. Due to resistance offered by the workpieces, the sheet metal, workpieces means we are talking about sheet metal, offered by the resistance to the flow of current, the temperature at the contact surfaces rises to fusion and the weld is completely on freezing. The operation is repeated by changing the position of the workpiece plate to get the weld at another point. The spot welding is widely used in automotive industry for joining vehicle body parts and in metal furnitures. So, this was the complete process how the spot welding works. Now, let us discuss some different points between the spot welding and the seam welding. The electrodes are in spot welding, the electrodes are pair of copper rods between which the sheets to be welded are positioned, and in seam welding the electrodes are a pair of rotating copper rolls between which sheets to be welded are passed. The welding takes place at discrete intervals. The seam weld joints are continuous, as we have already discussed. In between the rolls, continuous seam is produced along a particular straight path. Okay. In spot welding, it is used for components such as flat sheets, panels, as in car bodies. It is used to weld components such as fuel tank, shells and other applications which require the joint to be leak proof, you know, joint basically linear joint, straight line, linear joint. Okay. These are some differences, basic differences between spot welding and seam welding. So, now discuss, let us discuss seam welding, RSEW, resistance seam welding. The slide contact rolls are here, the upper electrode wheel, welding sheets are here, this is the lower wheel. Here this brown line, this particular brown line is showing welded portion which has been welded, because the rolls are moving in this direction, the rolls are moving in this direction. So, this workpiece is moving in this direction. So, rolls must have started from this position and welding has been done from here to here, welding has been done in a straight line by the pressure of these two rolls and the current passing from these two rolls. The seam welding happens. There is not much difference between spot welding and resistance welding, and seam welding. The only difference is basically the angle, the action, and mostly the applications. In spot welding only spots are produced, and in seam welding complete line of straight line of welding is done between two sheets. This is a process showing resistance seam welding. You can see here are two sheets and the rolls, these are the two sheets and the rolls are moving. Current is also passed through these rolls and thus the welding occurs at this particular junction throughout. At this particular junction, the welding occurs throughout in between these two roles. This is a particular setup of seam welding. Here is the machine, primary winding, welding machine is shown. These are two rolls, wheels are there, rolls, and base metal is this. Here is the base metal, stationary arm. This is the stationary arm. Okay, we can magnify here, and this particular figure, this portion into can be seen here. These are the two wheels. The movement is going here, and this blue color is the seam of the weld, which has been done by movement of the rolls. This is the cross section of the welded area within the two sheets. So, seam welding, let us discuss more about it. Seam welding is a resistance welding process of continuous joining of overlapping sheets. Here also overlapping is done by passing them between two rotating electrode wheels. Heat generated by the electric current flowing through the contact area and pressure provided by the wheels are sufficient to produce a leak tight weld. Seam welding is high speed and clean process which is used when continuous tight weld is required, such as fuel tanks, drums, domestic radiators, gasoline, automobile mufflers, and so on. There are numerous applications of seam welding. So, now let us discuss about another type of resistance welding, which is also known as butt welding. Resistance butt welding, it is of two types. First one is the upset welding, and the next is flash welding. So, moving ahead, what is butt welding? Especially, we are talking about the upset welding. Butt means sideways attachment, not the overlapping. In the seam and spot, the workpieces were overlapping, but in butt, they are sideways attached. Okay, fine. Butt means sideways joint of the metals. Butt. B-U-T-T, butt. So, in this, the two portions are applied on the sideways, and current is passed through these clamps. No electrodes are used. The current is transferred with the help of movable clamps, and thus the current passes from one workpiece to the another workpiece, and welding occurs at the junction, and this produces butt weld like this. This figure is showing the welding is done and current is removed. So, two shafts can be joined or two square bars can be joined using butt welding. The fundamental is same, that resistance of the two work pieces is being used under temperature and high pressure using high electricity, high current, low voltage power supply. Okay. Resistance butt welding, let us discuss it in more detail. Butt welding is used to join the pieces end to end. We have already discussed the process is best suited for rods, pipes, and many other parts of uniform cross section. Okay, fine. In upset butt welding, the parts are clamped and brought in solid contact, and the current is applied to that, the heat is generated through the contact areas of the parts. When the temperature of the interface reaches to plastic state, the current is switched off and the two parts are pressed together firmly. This results in lateral flow of the surface's oxide layers. This action of pressing together is called upsetting. But welding is used for welding small parts. The process is highly productive and clean. Upsetting means once the object, once the current is passed, then the force is applied on the two using the clamps. Clamps are placed here and here. Okay. If these two are the rods, then pressing will be done after the melting has occurred at the junction. Only then will be pressed and the metal gets joined sideways end to end. Now, this is the example of flash butt welding. Here electric arc is produced, mobile clamp is there, stationary clamp, the AC power is supplied in both the ends, and without applying the pressure there is a particular gap. There is a particular gap between the two sideways joints and arc is produced. Arc is produced here, and that arc normally joins as electric arc welding happens. This is flash welding, flash butt welding. Pressure is not applied in this case, or maybe little pressure is required. Flash welding is similar to upset welding, except that heat is obtained by means of an arc, then the simple resistance heating. The two parts are brought together and the power supply is switched on. As the parts are moved closer, flashing or arcing raises the temperature of the parts to a welding temperature. Now, power is switched off and the two parts are rapidly pressed. Yes, they are pressed and causing a small upset. This squeezes out liquid metal and oxides formed on the joint surfaces and the two parts are welded together. Thick pipes, end of bandsaws, frames, art crafts, landing gears are produced by flash welding. These are all various examples of flash butt welding. So, the main difference between the two weldings is that the flash welding uses the production of arc to melt the metal between the butt sideways of the joint, and the upsetting uses the internal resistance as of the spot welding to melt the metal. Both are pressed then for final joining. Now, comes to the resistance projection welding. Projection. What is projection? Projection, as we know, the impression of anything, means if we are making shadow of this palm, then this will be impression of this. So, simply projection is the shadow image we know. So, that can also be used, this concept can be used in welding. Let's suppose this die is here, and we have to weld on this sheet finally. Then sheet metal parts are pressed between these two electrodes. So, the projection will be weld at this particular projection, and this particular projection welding will be done. Okay. The resistance projection welding, starting of the operation, uses the two sheet metals. One is the actual shape, and the other one is projected shape after welding, means an impression of the one sheet on the other sheet is caused by welding process. A resistance welding is the process in which coalescence occurs at one or more small contact points on parts. Contact points determine by design of the parts to be joined may consist of projections, embossments, or localized intersections of parts. So, whatever design we want, let us suppose we want a zigzag design. So, on the other sheet it will be formed by producing, if we make a die like this. Oh shit. This will be a projection. Top electrode, which will be reversed, pressed on this bottom electrode to create a particular profile projection like this on both the sheets, and they will be joined together in this manner only. So, this is how the projection welding is carried on. So, that is all. Thank you for attending this session. Thanks a lot.